a little over a week before I leave for Africa, and this is Wisconsin in almost March. Yeah. Kind of hoping it's hotter in Africa.
Just finalizing everything, reviewing. Going over to Pat's tomorrow to print out my itinerary, all my vouchers, because apparently they have computers, but they don't know how to use them because everybody tells me to bring paper copies. I'm sure it's just smarter, and there's a good reason behind it. I'm just an idiot. And plus, you have the information on you. So, yeah, I guess I'm an idiot. But reviewing things, looking over my meds, getting all my meds that I need. They gave me two, one from malaria, which I take weekly. And the best part is the medicine may cause vomiting, especially in children. That right there makes me want to take this medicine even more. So I'm just here getting ready. So I'm finishing up packing, doing laundry for what I'm going to take with me. Most of it's ready. The usual. Sleeveless rock t-shirts. Monkey bar. Track jacket. Cannot travel internationally without it. Iron Maiden, of course. Shorts. Provide t-shirt for safari. My iPod for the plane. Noise canceling headphones is a must for international travel. I learned that the hard way with a small child behind me. Ex officio underwear. You need these. If you ever travel or are going to be gone for a while, they are a godsend. They don't fail you. Let's just put it that way. My new camera and swimsuit, a belt, and I got to go pick up sunscreen, seasickness tablets, which I don't think I need. Oh, I got my medicine somewhere for my diarrhea pills in case I get sick. And that's about it. Some socks and maybe some shoes and some sandals. And yeah, we're packed. That's it. So I'm gonna go get drunk in Milwaukee and enjoy my last night. We'll see you on the plane.
So beautiful, you made the sky your own. And then it disappeared, left you alone. Clouds were turning raindrops into sleet. Seagulls white like paper planes. Shadows leaving with no names. You're burning with the fever I can feel. You're burning with the fever that is me. Can you hear it?
Walking up Table Mountain, up a what is described as a path, but this is pretty much just broken rocks. This is a good part of the path, and Dan's probably like a half hour ahead of me because he's in shape, and I think I've had one bottle of water since we've been here. He drinks two, obviously, but he's in shape and drinks. Take the cable car if you ever come to Table Mountain. Fuck Table Mountain. Love, love is a verb. Love is a doing word. Feel a summer break. Gentle impulsion shakes. Here is one of the paths. As you can see, path is a very loose definition in Africa. The gentleman with the red backpack is Dan. He is climbing this right now, and I'm all the way back down here. I just got passed by family and small children, so I kind of have to keep going. I could use a beer.
Trump and fire.
I've basically made it to the top. Kind of just walking to an edge somewhere to see some more stuff. Nice panoramic views. Hopefully, food and drink. There's gonna be one point when you talk to me about this trip, and I'm gonna tell you how awesome it is to hike up Table Mountain. What a great and wonderful experience it is. And I will be completely lying in the very, very slim hopes that you come to South Africa and you walk up this goddamn mountain, because it is miserable.